Okay, so I guess it's about time I should cash in on that $250 credit from CBCS. So I'm going to send in 16 books, and let's see what I'm going to send. Stick around. Hey, and welcome back, family. Thank you for joining yet again here at Ohana Comics. Don't forget to click like, subscribe, and all the other fun stuff. I'll probably remind you again later, as I always do. So, if any of you guys have followed my trials and tribulations with CBCS, they lost a Stan Lee autographed book. And they either offered me the insured value that I put down, unfortunately, only at $150. I didn't think they were going to lose it. Or $250 credit. So I opted to take the $250 credit. And I've got the instructions on what to do. Submit the books and then forward the invoice to one of the head honchos and he'll apply the $250 credit. So looking at current pricing, 16 modern books would be $256. So I'm going to send 16 books and it'll cost me $6 plus shipping. So I'm going through the books and this is where it got fun because any book that I actually really, really wanted to get graded, I don't want to trust them with because of everything that's going on. Not on their website, they say the lead time is 25 weeks, which is 6 months, but I know that's a lie because I have books there already for over 6 months and other sources say that it's 8 months. So I picked out 16 books that I thought would look cool in slabs. I'm not worried about the grade because it's, what the heck, it's free. So let's go through. Picked out Donatello number one, the one-shot micro series. I had a copy of that. I thought that looked good. I have a copy of Shuri number one, the first print. I already have a CGC second print, and that's the tough one to get. I have that on a 9.8. So I figured, yeah, let me see if I can get that one slabbed. I have a copy of Marvel Secret Wars number one. Now, before you freak out, this is the same copy that I was getting ready to submit to CGC, and somehow I wound up getting a tape pull on the back cover. So this is gonna maybe be a 7.5 or an 8. I'm not even caring about the grades on these. I really am not. If a book comes back with a 2, I don't care. It's free. I'm just gonna try to have some fun with it, and that's what grading, you know, comic books is supposed to be. So I have not one, but 2 copies of Fantastic Four number 199. The Whitman variant. And the reason I have 2, this is actually another Shane story. So I was watching one of his Facebook Live auctions, and they had a box in the back, which was a grab bag. They had a lot of good books in there, and I'm trying to remember whether they were $5 each or $10 each. I think it was 10. So I said, you know, I put in the chat, pull me out 2 books. So he reached in the front of the box and he pulled one. He reached the back of the box and pulled one and pulled exactly the same copy of the same book. And he's like, oh, I'm so sorry. I'll put it back. I'll put one back. I'm like, no, do not put those back. I will take exactly what you just pulled out because the memory of you pulling out 2 identical books from opposite sides of the box in a grab bag is just too cool. And now I'm going to put them in slabs and keep them forever. I got a copy of Hawkeye Kate Bishop variant edition number 1. Another one that I picked out to send in is Star Wars number 7. It's the first issue that was after the movie. This is a regular, you know, newsstand edition. Well, I think it were pretty much all newsstand editions back then. Not the greatest copy, you know, so wasn't worried about that too much. Ghost Rider number 28, first appearance of the Midnight Suns. This is so up and down, it doesn't really matter. But I figured that I would send this off anyway, and it looks like it's got something in the back here that I have to find out what that is before I send it in. Don't know if that belongs here or not. Put that one on the side so I can double check that. A copy of Sleepwalker number 1. No collection is complete without that in it. I have a What If comic book here. It is What If Wolverine Had Killed the Hulk. I remember reading this too. There was another one that also, What If the Hulk Could Kill Wolverine? So, one copy of The Good Asian, first print. Let's see, what else we got? Now we have, that's 11 books so far, and I've got 5 books left, and they're all X-Men books. We've got X-Men number 145, nice cover with Dr. Doom. Number 147. Number 155. First appearance of Starjammers or something like that? I'm not exactly sure. Maybe the first appearance of Brood, somewhere in that time frame, I'm trying to remember. X-Men number 268, very popular cover. There you go. Again, none of these are 9.8 candidates, that's why I'm not worried about it. And I have a copy of number 282. I had picked up 4 copies of this, and this is the one copy that I looked at and said, nah, that's not a 9.8. The other 3 I already sent. So I figured, you know what, might as well get that one slapped. If it's free, why not? So those are my 16 books. Nothing's coming back a 9.8 in any of those. Again, why am I doing it? Because I just want to have some fun. try to get something out of this entire thing that'll make me smile. See, it's January now, so maybe for, like, we'll be looking at a Thanksgiving unboxing. I'm working on preparing another CGC submission, of which I'm going to send in all 6 of my copies of Timeless number 1, the Ramos Miss Minutes. Do I think they're going to hold value? No, I don't. But I do think that I've got 6 really good tries at 9.8. And when the next... when Loki Season 2 hits, or anything to do with Kang hits, and you see Miss Minutes on the screen, especially if she's in a trailer, that book is going to spike again. That'd be a good time to sell the books. And I just want to have the 9.8s handy to do so. So, are there any books here that you think that I'm nuts for doing this? Or you think I should have taken my 150 back? Or do you think I'm just, you know... what I'm trying to do is just stay true to the hobby itself, which is have fun. And you know, I'm going to have to pay shipping there and shipping back. And I will be getting signature verification with this. I don't care how much that costs. Because, man. Yeah, other than that, hope you guys are having a safe weekend. The weather here on the East Coast is a little bit on the crazy side. And everybody stay safe. It's the weather, you know, I'm in North Georgia and we're already looking at snow. We had snow and it's stuck. And it's already melting, but now the temperature's dropping below freezing, which means ice. Yay! So I'm going to try not to die on the way to work tomorrow. If I do, then my wife will be saying, yay, I get all the comics. Hopefully she won't say that. First she'll say, let's bury him, then she gets the comics. A little morbid there, Ohana. It's true. I just want to, like I said, have a little bit of fun. Don't forget to click like and subscribe. See, I did say it a second time. But other than that, I'm going to try to wrap this up, and thank you very much for watching. Wish me luck on the grading, not just the grades, but make sure, wish me luck that I get it back. And until I see you guys again, mahalo.